this afternoon from Kazia Therapeutics is James Garner. James, afternoon. Good to see you.
Good afternoon. Good to talk to you, Andrew.
Well, big bit of news from you this week around the fast track designation for Paxalisib. I want to talk in a bit more detail about that in a moment, but remind us where we are as far as the drug's development. Give us a bit of a recap.
We're developing Paxalisib for glioblastoma, which is the most common and the most aggressive form of brain cancer. And really tough disease, just one available drug for these patients doesn't work for two-thirds of patients. We've had the drug in a phase two human trial in the United States, and we've been seeing some great data coming out, some really encouraging signals that make it look like the drug has the potential to extend life. And obviously, we're looking to see that borne out now in a larger study, but at this stage, it's looking very promising. So we're in advanced preparations to move into a pivotal study for registration. That'll see the drug move towards market.
And I suppose the term fast track designation does what it says, but can you give us some specifics as to the opportunities it opens up for you?
That's right. It sounds encouraging, right? When you hear fast track, and it does do roughly what it says on the box. Fast track designation is awarded to drugs that are for serious diseases where there's an unmet medical need. So it's an acknowledgement that the existing standard of care is not sufficient in some way. And it also requires a drug to show the potential to improve on that standard of care. So some signal that it's either more efficacious or at least safer. So it's quite an exacting bar, actually. It asks quite a lot of a drug to achieve fast track. Once a drug gets it, then it provides really a much deeper level of engagement with the FDA. It a lot of extra opportunities for consultation, and also the opportunity to submit what we call a rolling NDA. So instead of putting in all of our documents right at the end of development and then waiting months and months and months for FDA to review them, we can put things in as we go. And that hugely speeds up and simplifies the process. So it's a really valuable step for us and really gratifying to have it.
And you've been looking also at the potential pediatric use of the drug, have you?
That's right. So we've been exploring the drug as well in a disease called DIPG, which is a rare childhood brain cancer. It's a really horrendous disease. It affects about 400 kids a year in the US, maybe one-tenth that number in Australia. 9 to 10 months survival from diagnosis, no available drug treatments at all. And we've been doing some laboratory research in the United States and Switzerland, and also particularly here in Australia at the University of Newcastle. And that's given us some great understanding of how Paxalisib may be able to help in DIPG. And there's a phase one human trial going on in the United States at St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. So we've actually got quite a lot of activity happening here. We recently received rare pediatric disease designation from the FDA. And this really, again, really just reflects the potential for the drug to provide benefit for kids with this disease. And it also has some real advantages. The biggest of these is the opportunity to access a priority review voucher, which is really an incentive to develop the drug for childhood illnesses.
Can we go back to the phase three study, the upcoming study here? Where are we as far as the planning?
We're in advanced stages of setup. There's been a lot of that sort of behind the scenes work, which is never fantastically exciting for investors, but it's important nonetheless. So we've really spent some months now working with our partners, working with clinicians to get that set up, and we're pretty nearly done with that work. I think we've got a few more I's to dot and a few more T's to cross, but it's coming together really well. We're on track at this stage to start our participation in the study by the end of the year. And I think that'll be a huge inflection point for Paxalisib. It's really moves the drug effectively to phase three and puts it on the final track towards registration.
And as the drug continues to move forward, what can you tell us about what the funding requirements will be?
We completed a funding round in April of this year. We raised $7.2 million from sector specialist institutional investors in Australia. And we had an accompanying share purchase plan for existing shareholders that raised an additional $1.8 million. So we've been very lucky. We've had great support from investors, both old and new. And that's put us in a strong position. We have money well into next year. Beyond that, I think there's quite a few options, quite a few ways we can go. And it's one of those things that's always very difficult to be specific until we get there. But in particular, we've always said that our long-term plan for the asset is to partner it with a larger company. And we're thinking about ways that we might structure that that enables us to partly fund some of the development work out of that. Beyond that, of course, we always have the opportunity of further discussions with investors, but we don't want to keep going back to them again and again. So I think we sort of try to keep that in reserve as much as we can.
Well, hard to believe, but September next week, and by the sounds, quite a critical remaining 4 months of the year for you.
That's right. It's been a whirlwind year so far for Paxalisib and for Kazia, and still a lot of work to do before we get to the end of the year. But I think it's been really gratifying that we've spent the last couple of years really just slowly, patiently, painstakingly investing the work in Paxalisib. And I think in the last 9 months or so, we've really seen that started to pay out. We've seen positive data. We've seen really important regulatory recognition. We've seen much greater investor interest in the program, and we've still got several data readouts to come, and of course commencement of the pivotal studies. So I think things are really going just as we would have hoped and planned, and it's great to see it moving forward.
Well, you talk about the investor interest. I think didn't your shares hit a 4-year high this week on the fast track news?
We've had a really positive response in the market. It's been fantastic to see. And huge volumes as well. So a lot of new shareholders coming into the stock. And I think that's terrific, because I think it's a lot of the work over the past few years has been that setup work. It's been that foundational work. And I think now the market is really waking up to the fact that there's a lot of results coming out of this. You know, we're already seeing some of that, some of that deliver, but I think there's a lot more to come. We're anticipating 2 or 3 more data readouts before the end of the year, and much more beyond that into the new year. So it's a great time to be on board with the Kazia story.
Good to see you, James. Thanks for the update.
Thanks, Andrew. Great to talk to you.